with Michael Baker this morning from Arovella Therapeutics. Michael, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Good to be catching up with you. You've announced here the successful completion of a $4.1 million placement, a share purchase plan now open, looking to raise up to $1 million. Tell us a bit more about the raise.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like all biotechs, right? We're always looking about making sure we've got the adequate runway and cash flow to support our ongoing development. So very pleasing in what most people would well understand is a pretty difficult market to have strong support for the $4.1 million placement, which was great. And certainly looking forward to the SPP, where giving our shareholders an opportunity to participate on the same terms as well.
Just while we're talking cash, and we didn't speak at the time, but of course the Perth R&D facility you've now closed. Just remind us of the rationale behind this decision.
Yeah, so that's an important strategic step for the company. So we would like to make sure that we have a razor-like focus on our iNKT cell therapy platform. And so to do that, it was deemed necessary that we'd actually close that facility down for two reasons. One, historical costs show that we'll save about $1.5 million now that we don't have that facility open with the ongoing developments. And of course, from a time perspective, right, it means our focus is now very clear, and there's no distractions away from our iNKT cell therapy, which we're looking to take into clinic.
And this was just one of a number of events which took place in the first half of the year. A busy 6 months for you. You've presented at a number of US conferences, plus been rounding out the team. Just give us a bit of a recap.
Absolutely. So we're delighted actually to present at the American Association for Cancer Research earlier in the year, which is a really actually one of the oldest and most revered cancer cell therapy focused conferences in the US each year. So we were selected to present, which was great. Had some really encouraging data presented, building off some of the changes in the manufacturing of our lead product, ALA-101, which we're developing for blood cancers. So it was great to present that data. We got a lot of interest from scientists, clinicians, even pharmaceutical companies. So it was great to have some discussions around that. And a few weeks ago, we presented in Boston at the Allogeneic Cell Therapy Summit. So again, it's good that we're getting some traction and making our presence felt in the iNKT cell space.
And of course, welcomed a new chairman, Dr. Tom Duthy.
Indeed, that's right. Tom joined only recently, and he's already hit the ground running in the company. Look, he's got a terrific amount of experience, I think, across the Australian sector, both medtech, biotech. So he's slotted in very nicely, and of course was instrumental to the recent capital raise. So delighted to have him on board.
Well, now that you are cashed up, Michael, what are the plans in terms of the next 12, 18 months? What are those big milestones?
So the focus for us is always to take ALA-101, which is our CAR-19 targeting iNKT cells, into phase one for diseases like non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And so we're going to be working through the manufacturing of that product for the second half of the year before looking to get the documentation ready for reg submissions to start clinical trials next year. So in terms of milestones, we're also excited that we've got expecting data to come for the Imugene partnership, where we're combining the two platforms, our ALA-101 and their oncolytic virus, which is quite exciting. And of course, some more things to come as well, but looking forward to updating the market as they mature.
Good to see you, Michael. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate it.